Alright guys, what is going on today? Welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm talking about the new Boruto episode 213. Now, if you guys watch this episode and read the manga, this follows manga chapter 45 and 46. So in this episode, we get to see the fight break out between Kawaki Koji and Jougan, who is then Ishiki Otsutsuki, which we find out in this episode. And Amado talks about the karma seal and gives an example of how the karma seal will slowly extract over time and will take over the host that it's been implanted on. So far, I like this episode. I like the way it was done. There was a lot of juicy stuff, mainly because it follows the manga chapter 45, 46. We get a lot of explanation on what was happening, and the soundtrack in this episode was really nice. It gave a lot of emotion to what Amado was explaining, and you see the fear in Boruto's eyes about how he will get taken over by Momoshiki one day. And it looks like Boruto has a little flashback to when he was given the karma, because as soon as Amado announces that the karma was given at the last second, you can see Boruto is kind of surprised. And that may be a hint to when Momoshiki was talking to him in the small little time stop, when he's like, one day those eyes will take everything away from you. And Momoshiki touches his hand at the very last second. He's like, those who defeat gods cannot remain a normal person. So it looks like Boruto maybe had a thought about that moment. Now, they did change some stuff in the anime that was not in the manga. For example, the scene where Kawaki Koji uses the flames from the mountain, Kawaki Koji states that those flames cannot be absorbed by the karma since they're natural. But in the anime, it looks like they changed it up and they don't mention that at all. Instead, you get Jigen saying these flames are, and just cuts out, and you see Kawaki Koji just smiling. So they removed that part out. They did add a extra part with Inojin, Shikadai, and Chocho. I didn't mind that. You can see Chocho's a bit worried about her teammate, but you can see that these kids aren't used to this type of stuff. Where she saw her own teammate was in danger of getting his head blown off, that she didn't know what to do. She was really worried. This goes to show the difference between the two generations. This last generation were all about war. This generation is more about peace. You can see that these kids aren't up to it. But they believe Naruto, who's the seventh Hokage, and even Inojin states that Naruto will take care of it. So another piece that the change between the manga and the anime is, if you look closely, is when Amado's first in the room, he puts the glasses down. While in the manga, he puts it down after he starts talking about the karma seal and everything. He's like, I'm getting a connection from my colleague. So then they start watching the projection and see Kawaki Koji and Jigen fighting. I'll be honest, the fight was okay. I didn't mind the fight, but I feel like it was missing the action the manga had. In the manga, it looks like they attack more, they go back to back more. And in this, the attacks felt a bit slow in my opinion, but it was still nice. So then during the fight, Naruto notices that Kawaki Koji fights like a certain someone, but he doesn't say the word. Even in the anime and manga, they kept that part out. They didn't say who it was. We're gonna find out who this person is next episode. So another piece I want to point out here is the fact that when Amado talks about Ishiki getting destroyed and how Kaguya betrayed him, the thing you notice here is that Amado doesn't mention that Kaguya caught him off guard or anything. As in the manga, he states that she took him down off guard. We don't know what Kaguya's real strength is, if she's stronger or not than Ishiki, because Amado himself does not explain how Kaguya beat Ishiki if he's supposed to be the strongest. Even Amado says that Ishiki, if he revives in Kawaki's body, he's unstoppable. And remember, this is pure Ishiki that she taken down. This is not somebody who's in a vessel. So it doesn't show how strong Kaguya is. That means Kaguya is pretty strong. They mentioned the infinite skumio. Well, in the manga, they don't mention the infinite skumio much. In the manga, Shikamaru asks Amado what will happen if the tree starts absorbing us. He's like, it's like a mosquito. It'll keep on sucking you until you're dry, and eventually you'll die, but they didn't add that part in. But one thing I will admit, I'm surprised with the fighting style between Kawaki Koji and Jigen. They didn't censor anything out. In the manga, as well in the anime, you can see Ishiki uses his rods and he stabs Kawaki Koji in the face and eyes. That's so brutal, but I'm surprised they kept that in there. They didn't blur it out or anything. The last thing I want to add, which is kind of weird though, in the manga and anime. In the manga, they don't mention anything about Kawaki Koji looking more into the karma seal. And same with Amado. Well, in the anime, Amado says that both him and Kawaki Koji plan to let Kawaki escape so that we can see what happens with the two karma seals between Boruto and Kawaki. It does make sense because Kawaki Koji, back in the chapter 20s, he let Boruto go and he was watching both Kawaki and Boruto and how their karmas resonate with each other. But in the manga, Amado didn't state that. Amado explained everything else, but he did not state that scene about them plotting together to watch how the karmas work. I feel like Amado knows much more about the karma, but he's not saying. I wonder why they added that part in the anime. Now, the other thing they added here was when Amado says that Kawaki is our secret weapon, that we let him escape. I feel like that's kind of bullshit, because last episode, you see Amado tells Kawaki Koji, he's like, we got our secret weapon. But I think that secret weapon was the information that Kawaki Koji went to go steal that was in the scrolls. And those scrolls have data about every shinobi before the fourth shinobi
war. And this goes back to chapter 60 when Amado makes a new cyborg, which is a really powerful ally. So I feel like that's a secret weapon. He's going to try reviving or make another cyborg related to somebody for the fourth shinobi war. That would make much more sense than saying Kawaki is a secret weapon. But then again, Kawaki could be something to Amado because Amado is after Kawaki's well-being even when Ishiki strikes. So there's a lot of stuff we don't know about Amado, so we're going to see how that plays out. But yeah, this episode just mainly talks about the karma seal, what it is, how it works, and all that sort of stuff. Like I said, I like the fight scene. It was really nice. I like the way this episode went. It was actually really engaging. It was so hyped up. I can't wait for the next episode. Anyways, this is what I think. Thanks for watching. Please comment, like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos to come.